They are just like the most famous people in the, on the planet at the moment.
You better believe it!
Spice Girls are going to show you how to make a movie.
Here we go.
Spice Girls set to conquer the globe. Why is it that I can't pick up a paper without seeing them all over the front page?
Next Saturday, 8 o'clock, for the first time ever, the Spice Girls are going to perform live for the very first time here at the Albert Hall.
Since the Beatles films, really, I can't think of a single English film that's been made or a reason to make a film that seems so purely for the sort of the pop of it.
Right, you horrible lot!
Stop right now, thank you very much. I need somebody with a human touch.
We thought that, you know, we weren't just about music. We felt that, you know, we're five really good friends here and we want to have a go at as much as we can. And the movie was something we've always dreamt about. We had a lot of input on the movie as well, down, you know, from the casting, costumes, director,
brilliant,
everything. And we wrote our album at the same time, which is actually Spice World, which is the soundtrack.
Spice Girls are going to show you how to make a movie.
Here we go.
Well, I didn't know who they were. And I got a call from the writer, who I do know, and said they're going to make a Spice Girls movie. And I said, who are they? I then made a couple of calls. One was to Jennifer Saunders, you know, about something else. And she said, you lucky boy. So I thought, oh, well, I might as well, you know. And then I met the girls in Beverly Hills. But it wasn't until I got home at Christmas, my 9-year-old daughter put Spice Girls record on 24 hours a day for 7 solid days, that I really knew what it was all about.
When we got together, it was something that we wanted to do. We said to ourselves, we're not just a band, we want to try everything.
I really need some great actors in the film, and I was thinking about, you know, Richard E. Grant.
Jerry and Emma said, you are going to be in this film, aren't you? I said, yes, of course.
The whole chief. They've got fire in their eyes, hunger in their bellies, and great big shoes on their feet. I'm telling you, chief, they're raring to go.
His character is excellent.
Clifford is neurotic.
Look at that! More stories, more evil harpoons from the press.
It's all lies, I tell you! Bring me a straight dagger!
He plays like our manager.
He has very little power, and gets stomped over by them.
From now on, there's no more Mr. Nice Spice.
Be sporty, you do have to be sporty, because I hurt myself being sporty. I had a stiff neck and a bad leg afterwards.
And to be scary, you have to have a bit of a mouth on it. Because I couldn't do it.
And to be ginger, you used to have to go like that.
And to be posh, you'd have to be very uncomfortable all the time. Look at them shoes, man.
What did you do?
Well, to be babe, you have to have incredibly strong legs, because have you seen the boots she wears?
These.
Incredibly strong legs to be able to dance in those.
I'm so sporty!
My mummy's my best friend.
I'm just too posh.
When the Liverpool gonna win the Cup, eh?
Are we finished yet?
Blah blah blah. Girl power, feminism. You know what I mean? Oh no. Yo.
Hard Day's Night did come up in the conversation. You know, when we were discussing it earlier on, and Spinal Tap. And so you kind of think these are two pop movies that we liked, and people haven't made pop movies for a long time. So yes, they were influences, but then I think we just took it. You just go off and make your own film, you know.
I want to know. Jerry's actually drawn a picture of somebody in the audience.
And guess
can
who
you
it
identify
is
yourself, please?
I think you know it's gone a bit serious. Should we do a Mexican wave? Yeah. Should we start up there?
Yeah.
Down?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah.
So, otherwise, we're not continuing the press conference.
Ha ha ha!
look really cool, man.
Jerry was the one that organised what characters we should be. Yeah, look at us. And look at Jerry. And it looks.
All the characters that we chose are basically the ones that we admire, but also fitting with us, I think.
This is the actual costume that Wonder Woman wore. But I think she had a smaller waist than me.
Amblin Pierce Guttons and Smythe, who's trying to make a documentary about the Spices.
Come on, boys! Capture that magic!
But he has very little success because he is pretty dippy.
So what I want to do with this documentary is show the real Spice Girls.
It's like we're really intensive, trying to make a really hard-hitting documentary, and then we really craft it.
You know, I want to break through the showbiz facade. I want to crash right through it and reveal the truth.
Well, that's fine. Just so long as you crash through the showbiz facade on schedule and don't get in anybody's way.
The film is self-parodying, and the girls, you know, are very good at, you know, taking the mickey out of themselves and having fun with the whole Spice Girls thing that's going on, the whole phenomenon.
You don't have a life. You have a schedule. You are part of a well-oiled global machine. There are people everywhere working their butts off for you.
The girls cannot have the morning off.
Sorry, Chief, just an idea.
Jerry, did you really pinch Prince Charles's bum?
I am a professional bottom pincher.
She pinches everyone.
I pinch everybody's bottom, and why stop at a prince? Come on.
What was it like?
Pardon?
What was it like?
Wobbling, no, joke.
I'm not. That's classified.
That's classified. You know, that's for me to know. I had the pleasure of doing that. So I'm not going to tell.
But we all know.
But it was not bad. I'll say that.
We had a list of people that were technically available. You know, the casting director made up a big long list of the wish list. And we got most of the wish list, actually.
Girl power!
I had a little bit of fun a couple of months ago. The Spice Girls asked me to appear in their movie, The Spice Girls, the movie. So I just happened to be free, because they offered me a lot of money.
Really good reason to say it.
No, it was fun. The girls were nice.
When the speeding melon hits the wall, it is Christmas for the crows.
What did he say?
I haven't a clue.
It's all glamour and it's all really lovely and they treat you really well.
The Spice Girls.
All right, we're coming. If you want to be my
lover. Is my dress too short?
No.
We've been shooting now for 42 days. The girls are never off screen. They've been very professional. We've kept absolutely to schedule.
The schedule is so tight, we even have to rehearse in the dressing room.
Which is remarkable. And, you know, they've given me everything I could ask for, basically. In just, you know, their natural talent and professionalism.
The usual day filming is up at the crack of dawn, 6.
We all come in with wet hair, no makeup, looking absolutely lovely. And then, once we're all done, we go on to film and we're ready for the day.
Well, that was the Spice Girls, and if you want tickets for their first ever live gig, tough luck, you're just too late. But they're with me now on surgery, so here they are. Welcome, girls, they're sporty, oh, scary.
Turn baby. It off.
Ginger.
All right.
Oh, well. Emma, come on, what's it like to be Baby Spice?
Yeah, I'm always going to be seen as Baby Spice, you know, the sweet and innocent one. Even when I'm 30.
You love it, really, Emma. You play up to it all the time.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do. You're doing it now.
I'm not.
We've done this before.
Oh, no more. Well, this one.
It's a bit long, aren't you?
And sometimes it's really quick and sometimes it goes on and on and on. But we do it and we get through it because we've got girl power.
Well, what about relationships back home you have to hold on to, perhaps, you know?
No, if you have a relationship
boyfriend,
back home,
boyfriend.
Then, you
Victoria,
know.
Would you like to answer? You haven't said very much.
You know what? Sit down.
I haven't said anything. I mean, yes, me not.
Sit down. Sit down. Sit down.
Come on.
No, I think, you know, you've got a phone time. And if you want things to work, then it will work, you know. If you want things to work, it will work. But, you know, we're at home quite a bit of the time and...
Yeah, but
there's
like,
always the telephone.
There's always the phone.
Exactly. You can get those. In actual fact, you can get those phones that you can actually see people at the other end on now, can't you? So you don't even have to see somebody in the flesh. So there you go.
You know, there's a lot of input from the girls, but mainly on telephone because they were flying around the world all the time.
And also, the other thing, I mean, we have five friends here. We support each other. We're about female solidarity, so it's brilliant. I'm we're all so glad to be in a group. So we've got girl power.
Give it up! Give it up!
Who knows what's going to happen? All we know is that we're going to stay friends no matter what happens.
Yeah. We love, you know, we love to perform, we love to entertain, and, you know, the biggest thrill for us is seeing, like, smiles put on the faces of our fans.
Yeah.
It's really too hot in here.
I need a fan.
We were singing about on our own experiences, you know, about safe sex, you know, and we were wanting girls out there to identify how we feel.
What was that you said?
If I promise to get it right, will you put me in the movie?
Show me your abdominal muscles and I'll think about it. He can play the villain. I mean, he is the media.
And now Emma is demonstrating how to deal with intrusive photographers.
The rest is on, so get out of the bathroom. The
top is... That's good! Do it again!
I think the boat stuff was the most difficult. I think doing all that stuff in the docks was... Just because we didn't have... You know, we were meant to be doing some big stunts, but we weren't on a big movie budget. Do you know what I mean? We weren't making Die Hard or something. So we had to, you know, work really fast and very active.
Have you noticed how the Spice Girls get these lovely, stylish, posh ones? And we get the World War II leftovers.
Yeah, why is that?
That's because these are style icons.
I enjoy it. I enjoy it. I like being filmed.
All right, girls.
I had to save the day and I had to drive a bus zooming around London, which was a lot of fun.
We always wanted to go out and conquer the world, and it was like, it's a bit of a joke really, do you know what I mean? And we're just pushing it to the boundaries and seeing how far we can go.
I can make it happen, Brad! Me, Kevin McMaxford, I put him up there, I can bring him down! Yes!
It does represent that we have been hounded from day one by the press. On the end of the day, you know, the press are part of our lives.
Top of the skirts, thank you very much.
They'll try and do anything to get their photo, basically.
Even when we're filming, you know, we get chased by paparazzi. I mean, Richard O'Brien, he actually plays like a paparazzi photographer throughout the film. And, you know, he pops up everywhere. And that is, you know, more or less, I mean, obviously exaggerated, but that is what it's like for us.
I am Baby Spice. You know, even though we discuss it in the thing, I don't mean I don't like being Baby Spice, just that, you know, because I'm always the cutesy one. It's nice because that's who I am. But sometimes I can be hard as well.
I think quite a few people are going to be surprised when they see, you know, see the film, because even though like we're our own characters, they've been taken to the max. And funny enough, I smile a few times in this film, so it's a bit of an exclusive there.
The film is like one massive tornado.
Action alien!
Action alien!
Doing?
This is the Royal Albert Hall, and it will soon be filled with more screaming children.
The day we did the live concert was absolutely amazing.
Everything's really quite normal. To us, it's just everybody on the outside going a bit, whoa!
You know, I had enough cameras, and, you know, I could see what was going on. It looked very good to me.
Then we walked out on the stage, and everybody just went absolutely berserk.
But, I mean, the amazing thing is they are completely, you know, relatively unaffected by it all.
When you're feeling sad and low, we will take you where you gotta go. Smiling, dancing, everything is free. All you need is positivity.
We like the Lombardi.
Yeah,
big time.
we took a trip to South America actually before that one. And we were very influenced by the Latino music, and that's where we got the inspiration for Spice Up Your Life. In in our experience of South American girls, they are so passionate about things. I think they've all got girl power, don't they?
Yeah, definitely. They're very sexy race.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you can be strong. Sexy and have brains at the same time. Yeah. Mm. Now that's girl power. Deadly combination. Yeah. Girl power does work.
You just walk in, I make you smile.
I see ya, hold tight.
But we'd like to say a massive thank you to all our fans.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you.
And I hope you really enjoyed the movie.
Thank you.
A lot.
Girl power.
Right, no, I don't want out.
Get off.
Excuse me.
What do you think of this one?
Right. Yeah.